On today's build-up, we're going to be putting together the 1971 Ford Mustang Mach I 007 car. They got the license for it, 1/25th scale from Diamonds Are Forever. Check it out. Now, I did build that 70 Galaxy. They got a copy of the movie poster, Sean Connery's last time he played 007. And we're going to put this bad boy together and take a look at everything that's in the box. So let's start getting out some parts. It is pre-molded in red if you wanted to do as minimal paint detail as possible. They got the optional engines in this thing and a lot of optional parts that don't have anything to do with the movie, so you don't have to build the movie version. You got one with a full roll cage. We've got separate engines, intake options, all kinds of cool stuff on there. We got seat belts and harnesses. Depending on how you want to take the model, we got some wheel backs there, just off on their own little tree in the box. We got that nice dashboard. We got parts of a roll cage in there. The dashboard is nicely detailed. We got our steering wheel on that tree. On these little trees over here, we're looking at some more wheel backs. Looks like a firewall. These are older style kits, so they won't be massive detail monsters, but they're very nice. We got manifolds on there. We've got a transmission. We've got some pans there. We've got an air cleaner. On this one, we've got our racing seat. We've got our stock bucket seats. We've got an optional hood scoop on that thing. We've got our suspension and drive line for the rear. We've got our dual exhaust system. Let's get out some more stuff. We've got an intake here. You can see it's got for the velocity stacks there. We got our radiator support. On this tree, man, this thing's got so many parts in it. We've got more of a racing style dashboard. We've got window louvers. We've got a block and transmission section. We've got more intakes, more manifolds, headers, heads, roll cage parts, tons of options in there. Oh, there's the spoiler right there. On this tree, we've got our hood with our scoops. We've got a battery. We've got the side mirrors. Don't lose those. They're real little on there. We've got our center tunnel. Looks like another radiator support for a version. Looks like we've got a back seat delete. At least that's what I think it is. We've got the Mustang body. We've got the interior. We've got the chassis pan. Nice basic detail on these. Being vintage kits, you don't have to spend a ton of time worrying about tiny details. We've got the door panels in there. They are quite shallow, but you can get in there. We've got our center console molded in, the stock console, with our back seat and our package shelf for the fastback, the Mach 1. And we've got that nice 71 Mach 1 body. Let's see how the front end is molded. Nice trim on the sides. Got that fastback look to it. Looks like it's pretty straight. I don't see any warping of the body. Should be able to get it on there tight. I'm going to go to the other side of the desk. We've got the new decal sheet to make the Diamonds Are Forever car. That's nice that they put that chrome trim in that goes in, or the silver trim that goes in between the cut line on the paint. That'll make it easier and help you correct any mistakes. We got that nice surround on the back. Mach 1 emblems, all kinds of marker lights, dash decals, two sets of dash decals. We got the engine air cleaner decals, Mustang decals, the movie license plate. So you're all set there. What else we got over here? We've got transparent red tail lights, headlights, marker lights, and the front and back glass as separate pieces. We've got a loose intake in the box, high-rise intake there, all chromed up. We've got a beautiful chrome tree here. You can see our rear tail lights, our grille bezel in the front. We've got optional wheels. We've got the stock wheels for the 71 in the movie. We've got bumpers, carburation, it looks like wheelie bars.
cylinder heads, extra gauge packages. So this isn't just a standard kit. This one's got a lot of parts in it. Of course, we got the steel axle, and we've got four white wall tires, hollow, black on the other side. I don't see a label for a name on them, just the white wall and the nice tread pattern on there. That's everything that's in the box. I'm going to be building this one from Sean Connery's last 007 movie because he passed away recently. I'm going to start building mine. We'll be right back. Here we go. It's sub-assembly show-off time. We've got it all set up. I've got the body parts on. I test fit the chassis. The chassis pretty much just falls right in. It's got these large pins and everything. It is in vintage kit, so it's made to just kind of push together. There's not going to be any tight fits or struggles or anything like that. So, got the differential on the back with the springs and the drive shaft. You can see everything mounts right to the solid bars here across the back. The front tires, you can adjust the height and the rear in three different levels there. So that'll make it easy, and then we'll just paint that. We'll detail a little bit underneath, and we'll be all set to go. I'm not going for a factory perfect. I'm just going for a nice movie car, and they use multiple different cars with different details and damage and stuff. We got the exhaust cut off. That's ready to go, be painted up a metallic color. We've got the wheel backs all set up. The rear wheel backs are a separate part in the kit. These were loose, so those will be used with that metal axle in the back. We've got those set to just be painted black behind those hubcaps. The front wheels, I've got the pins. I always glue mine in with model glue. You can leave those loose, press them together, and still let them roll. That's completely up to you if you choose. The dashboard and the steering wheel, we'll do the recommended color in the manual. The radiator mount with the battery already glued to it, that's going to be black underneath the hood, so we can just do that all in one part and detail it separately with little markers later. We've got the fan and the pulley for this engine that goes in this kit glued together with super glue, and then we'll be spray painting that. I will be attaching the alternator at a later date. I am going to use the belts. You don't have to, but I like them. They're easy to detail, and they add a nice amount of detail when you look inside the window. The rear trim, this is mostly black except for the edge, so what I like to do on these is spray it all black, then go in with a Molotow or silver marker and do the trim. It's much easier than trying to just paint these inserts all black and get it right. It's easier to spray it, pick out the detail later. The hood's ready to go. I already test fit it in the body and it fits lovely, so we leave it on that little sprue cut off. Then we will just cut that off, do our chrome trim around there, and touch up the paint as needed, and we're all ready to go with the hood. I always remove any kind of hood hinges or pins on mine. One, it makes the fit much nicer. Two, nothing interferes, and I don't ever plan on displaying my hoods open. I just like them flat to begin with. That's a personal choice that I like to do. The interior pushes into the body very nicely. It uses this little hoop on the back. That lines up with this pin back here. You can hear it more than you can see it. It's very, very shallow. There it is. That lines up, and then when that's all together, I glued on my firewall to make sure that it would all line up properly. It's got little edges on it, so we can glue it in. Now I'll be able to paint this, primer it all, and then detail the interior to my heart's content. Got the air cleaner all set to go on its little tree. We'll get that painted up and detailed. Got the rear license plate frame. We'll get that painted so we can glue that on towards the end with some super glue. Got the seats glued together. You can see they fit together nicely. Those seats will be painted up. I've got to detail that inside triangle area with some black, but otherwise the seats are set to go. We got our 351. It's not the best model of a 351. It will survive for this kit. It'll be just fine, but I've got that. I'm going to primer it all black, get it painted my choice of blue for a Ford, and then we will detail the manifolds, the distributor, and anything else we need to do by hand, and I enjoy doing that. The body is all glued together. I find out you can glue all the body parts, front and rear, on the model, and still get the chassis to just fall right inside, so don't worry about that. I also glued on the mirrors since they are body color. I want them glued on with model glue so that they weld together and hold tight. Those new parts for 71 model on the front end, you can see them on there. You'll get a better view of that, of course, too, once we get some paint and it's not all one color. But you can see all those go together. I'll just have to get in here with some black, then add my chrome trim. That won't be a big deal. And I'm glad that those mirrors look nice on there. They are glued on with model glue. The back fits on absolutely fine. Glued it all on with model glue. Now it's set. Now I can get it in the paint booth and get working. The chrome parts I'll be leaving chrome are the grille surround in the front and the wheels. There's no reason not to leave those wheels as chrome because they are chrome in the real one. And I'll be black washing inside. We'll show all of that when we're done with painting. We'll be right back. After all the detailing, final assembly is going pretty good so far, not having any fit issues. The dashboard fits down into its inserts very nicely. You can see that interior looking good. That dashboard that I was working on looks fantastic. Didn't use a bit of decaling on there, just did it the way it is. We got the belts in there, and I got the seats painted up the way they said the seats should be painted up on the manual there for the movie car. So we're doing pretty good. Minor detailing on the door panels. The detail's very shallow. Did a little bit of that wood graining, same as I did on the dashboard, and now we've got that all set and ready to go. At the end, I'll have a closer-up shot of the interior dashboard, but you can see the belts look nice. It looks more realistic that way. The firewall's still black for under the hood. Speaking of under the hood, we've got the 351 bolted in. Very basic detail. Did a little detailing on the battery there. Got the radiator mount glued in place. And then underneath, as a tire falls off and it has a horrific wreck, we've got the underbody. The exhaust lines up beautifully, as you can see. And actually, that should be a little off to the side there. I left it loose so that I can adjust it if the body has to come down or whatnot. I've only got it glued up towards the front. And that's the way I like to do it. Then I blacked out the tips with a magic marker. So that is how it looks. You can see all the wheel and tire package looks on there. I haven't glued any of the wheels or tires on because the manual doesn't even mention three holes being in here on the front and back. So I don't know where to put them. I have to get the body on, then I'll know where to put the wheel and tire package for the ride height. The rear just mounts on with that steel axle. The front wheel and tire, which looks awesome, goes in with just the pin, so I'll have to decide based on ride height where it is. And it won't be a problem on this car because this car doesn't completely surround or lay over the top of the tires where you can't slide them in. Got the air cleaner ready to glue on when we're all done for its decal, and the body is all done. We got the nose done, we got our trim work around our locks and our door handles, we got the mirrors, we got the glass in as you saw, and we got the rear end on. All the trim with that nice black line. All I need to do now is add the silver stripe between the red and the black, the black stripe around the tail, the Mach 1 emblems and the reflectors, and we are all set to go. So I'm going to push things together, figure out where those wheels and tires go, glue that all together, then apply the decals, throw it back into that dehydrator for about 30 minutes at 90 to 100 degrees to let the decals set. Then we'll give it two coats of future floor polish. Everybody, not everybody, but so many people ask in every video, guys, I don't lie, make things up about these cars. When I say I brush on the future floor polish, I take a brush and I brush it on. I've shown this dozens of times. You reply in the comments, oh, what kind of brush do you use? It doesn't matter. Just brush it on with a soft brush and let it sit and dry. I've shown this numerous times, so thanks for always asking. Check out the other videos like the Concept Camaro, the old Milwaukee video. You'll see how I do it, but when I say I brush it on, I just brush it on. I'm promising you, there's no magic, there's no secrets. I'm gonna finish buttoning everything up, and I'll be right back.
First build video of the new year. We're starting out right with the 1971 Ford Mustang Mach 1 from Diamonds Are Forever, issued by AMT, the 007 car. They've made all different kinds of models of these over the years, die casts, kits like this, and it's fun if you are a big Bond fan. Also, remember, all those extra parts that were in the box that we looked at, you don't have to build it absolutely bone stock. You can swip those white walls around. You can use the other wheels, you can build the other engine, you can put the roll cage in it, you can do whatever you want with it, you can put the velocity stacks on it, all that kind of stuff, and make it your own. But I wanted to do it just like the box, especially because we just lost Sean Connery, and that's a big loss to anyone who enjoys 007 or just great movies in general. The guy was a lot of fun and a great actor. So I decided where to place the wheels. I did it in the center hole of the three. Next time I might do the front wheels one hole up to drop that front end a little bit. But a lot of the cars from the 70s, especially the sports style cars, sat a little bit, or they at least looked like they sat a little bit in the lower end. And I do like the look of it in that position. The decals went on nicely. The very thin gray stripes, I did have one of them start to break and splinter on me, but they give you extras, and I was able to salvage the one that started to splinter, and you really can't even tell unless you get up close with a microscope, and I don't do that with my builds. That Krylon paint
works absolutely well. I didn't name it in the video, but the black on the bottom was just Tester's Gloss Black out of a can. Sprayed it on there with the Krylon Red Pepper on the top, and then you saw me do my detailing. That interior looks awesome. Done up the way the box asks you to, with the black dash and console, the red seats and all that, and the red door panels with the wood trim. The underhood is not as detailed as a modern kit would be. It's definitely a vintage kit, but it does look cool. And then you got that underbody, very basic underneath there, that we detailed up and had a lot of fun with. So the white walls and those hubcap style wheels definitely make the model. If it wasn't for those, it wouldn't look like the movie one. They're very specialized. We got that nice rear bumper. I thought that would be difficult to work with, but as you can see, it just pushed in. And I used dollar store super glue as always for my final assemblies. Brushed the two coats of Future on it, threw it in the dehydrator for 30 minutes, dried it up real nice, and we are all set to go. So I enjoyed it. I want to thank Round 2 for sending this over. Thank all of you for the good year in 2020 we had. We're starting 2021 off right with a sweet-looking bright red 351 Mustang out of Diamonds Are Forever, James Bond, Sean Connery. Thanks for watching. Build your models for you the way you want to see them, nobody else. Have fun, and we'll see you at the next video.